Adobe Illustrator has launched a new tool called the Dimension Tool, and with this you can create measurement guides with just a few clicks. So let's see how it works. Alright, I'm inside Adobe Illustrator and I have a packaging design layout here. I'm gonna select the Dimension Tool that you can find here, and it's gonna show this little bar. You can move it around as you want. It contains three different subtools, each for a different type of measurement, which we'll go through one by one. So the first tool that we have here is the linear dimension. To use it, what you're gonna do is simply left click on any point where you want to start making the measurement, and it's gonna start showing you this nice guide. You can press the shift key to make a straight line. And I'm gonna go right till the last edge of the packaging where it shows another guide. I'm gonna press the left key, and now you can see the guidelines are moving upward. Finally, you can click on any point where you want the measurement to sit, and that's it. You can see the arrows on each side of the line, and also the exact measurement is shown here. Now this measurement is written in pixels, because if I click on the rulers, you can see that the current scale is set to the pixels, so it's following that here. Now there are a few ways to change this. If I go to the properties panel, you can see all the settings to customize the look of the measurement. From here you can see all the available units. I'm gonna select millimeters, and you can see it updated on the left side. You can also set the measurement precision into 2 decimals or 3 decimals. I'm gonna keep it to 2 decimals. Next, I'm gonna increase this font size so that it's more visible. And change the font style to semi-bold. You can also change the position of the text. I can move it to the left, move it to the right, in the center, also below, or above the line. I'll change its color to some dark red color. Next, I'll add some weight to the line and increase the arrow size. You can also change the arrow style. I'll pick this one. You can make it a dashed line or a dotted line, but I'll keep it to solid line. I'll change the extension line color to gray and make it a dashed line. I'll change the dimension line color to blue. Now that looks much better, and you can do the styling as you want. Before I make any new measurement, I'll change the ruler unit to millimeters. Also, if this video is providing any value to you, then please take a moment to like and subscribe. That is gonna help me a lot to make more videos for you. Alright, left click to start the measurement. Press and hold the shift key for a straight line. Press the left click one more time to start the extension line, and then click again. You can see that the style of this line is not followed on this measurement, and let me tell you why is that. If I go to the tool settings, you can see the default style in here. You can change the default style settings as you want. After that, click on save and it will be applied to all the new measurements. Another thing you can do is select the measurement, and in the properties panel, I have this option to apply the styling to all the new measurements. Click on it and you can see it applied here. Next, we have the angular dimension, and to use this, you got to left click, hold it, and drag your mouse to see these guides. Then release the left click on any point to place the measurement. And you can also make the measurement on the outside of the shapes. Release the left click to place it, and that's it. Alright, next we have is radial dimension, and you can use it to measure the radius and circumference. Let me zoom it so you can see better. Now listen carefully. All I'm gonna do is move my mouse to the outer edge of the semicircle. Click on any point, and it's gonna create a radius measurement. Now this text is overlapping the line, so I'm gonna go into the properties, and I'll increase the offset. Next, I'll create a radius measurement on the circle. Now to create a circumference measurement, move your mouse to the outer edge. You need to click and hold it, then you'll start seeing a complete line going through the circle. Release the mouse button to place the measurement, and there it is. If you're wondering, this R indicates the radius, and these 5 signs mean the circumference. Looks good so far. I'll select this measurement and apply its style to all the others. And look at that, it's applied to all the measurements. Looks better now. If I zoom in, you can see the text is overlapping on some of the lines. So I'll select this measurement from the properties panel, click on expand, now is separated, and you can move it as you want. I'll actually decrease the text size and offset for this one. Same goes for this. I'll increase the offset for this one. And that's it. There's another thing I want to show you. Let me select the linear dimension. I want to make a measurement on this diagonal line. And you can see I can also elevate the measurement in a diagonal direction, which is very helpful. I'll make another measurement and place it here. Now I'm gonna select both of these and manually stylize this time. And that's it, looks great. This tool is not just limited to the packaging design, you can use your own creativity on any type of the design. Let's actually do this quickly on a logo design, what do you say? So I have this logo here, and I have changed the default measurement styling that you can see here. Now I'll make a few measurements, and all the styling will be automatically applied. As you can see, it's very easy to create measurements with this tool. Don't know why Adobe took so long to introduce this tool, but I'm glad it's finally here. Cause earlier I had to manually make such measurements, which is a very tedious task, but now all it takes is just a few clicks. So that's how you can use dimension tool in Adobe Illustrator. It's a great feature, try it yourself and share your experience in the comments below. If this video was helpful, then please give it a like and subscribe. Your support is much appreciated. Thanks for watching and I'll see you in the next video. Have a great day.